Hello everyone, this is Crazy Ste, and today I want to talk to you about the ugly monster that haunts turbo engines, the LSPI, or Low Speed Pre-Ignition. What is it and how do you prevent it? Well, to show you how to deal with this, we're going to use my car. It is a Honda Veloster Turbo. It's a 1.6 liter turbo engine with 200 horsepower. It's the GDI engine, GDI turbo. And right now we're gonna start driving and keep an eye while we talk about the LSPI. I'm gonna start driving here on this road. Not quite the best to drive a manual car while holding the camera, but that's okay. What is the LSPI? LSPI, it stands for Low Speed Pre-Ignition, and it is a phenomenon that happens in single-staged turbo engines that have generally a high-spec power. For instance, this is a Honda Veloster. It's got a 1.6 liter GDI turbo with 200 horsepower. That means that if you divide 200 by 1.6 liter, you obtain about 135. That's 135 horsepower per liter. That's a pretty high spec power. And engines with this type of specs, they tend to be more exposed to the effects of the LSPI. But what is LSPI exactly? Well, as the name says, it's a low speed pre-ignition, which it doesn't have to do with the actual speed you're traveling at, but rather with the RPMs that your car is traveling, the engine is spinning. And when you are in the LSPI range, what happens is that the fuel detonates before the piston reaches the top dead center. Now, I assume that you understand enough about engines to know what I am talking about. They say that one of the ways to prevent LSPI is to use some different oils, lubricants that they are supposed to help prevent the LSPI effect. But honestly, those are just I don't know how much really a different lubricant can help. I mean, you can try to use a different lubricant, but you'll see in a moment when we discuss the how the LSPI happens that shouldn't really much be the issue. Rather, you should try to use a higher octane fuel, and that will help with reducing the LSPI effect. How does LSPI happen? Well, LSPI typically affects smaller engines with fixed geometry turbo, like my car, my Honda Veloster. They tend to be affected when the turbo sends too much air pressure into the engine, and when the piston goes up in the compression cycle, it causes the pressure to increase so much that the temperature reaches a point at which the fuel will simply ignite, meaning that the fuel will ignite before it reaches the top dead center, basically pushing backwards the piston before it's supposed to do so. And well, if you search LSPI, you will soon find out that, you know, the GDI turbo appears in the top of the list, but there is a bunch of other engines that they are at risk of LSPI. And honestly speaking, there is a very simple way to prevent LSPI, and you are watching it right now. The LSPI happens, like the name says, at low speed. Low speed intended as RPM. In the case of the GDI turbo engine, it tends to happen between 2600 and 2900 RPMs. So the solution you've been watching me driving for the last little while, it's rather simple. You drive above 3000 RPMs. That's what I've been doing since I bought the car. And online in the years I've seen so many posts of people that they tell me, oh man, you better sell your Veloster by the time you get to 50,000 miles because you're gonna blow the motor, a piston is gonna fall off, and blah 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 blah. Everybody complaining about this LSPI, people that says, oh, if you make it to 60,000 miles, you're lucky because the LSPI is gonna kill your car first. Well, not really. You can just prevent the LSPI by simply driving away from the range which Honda recommends. Now, right now, well, right now we're doing 55 miles an hour. I am in fourth gear. Go figure why Honda tells me that it's time for me to insert the sixth gear. Definitely not the type of thing that I want to do, because if I went to sixth gear right now, I definitely would end up causing LSPI. And this is quite a problem with these cars, because especially if you have an automatic gear car, well, it's gonna tend to keep the RPMs lower, and that's because a lot of people tend to prefer keeping the RPMs low because supposedly it uses less gas. But that's not quite that true. You can keep the engine at the higher RPMs and just feather in the throttle, just like I am doing, and you obtain pretty good gas mileage. I mean, you don't need to press hard on the throttle to go up in the RPMs. You just feather it and keep the engine a little bit in the happier range, and it works a lot better. Smaller engines, they naturally tend to generate the best torque at the higher RPMs. The turbo tries to give extra torque at lower RPMs, but honestly, it's not quite great, because as we said, the turbo tends to push a lot of air into the engine, and in the case of the GDI turbo, it's got the perfect trifecta, because it's a direct injection engine, it's got a single stage or fixed geometry turbo, a fixed geometry turbine, and it's a pretty big size turbine, so it tends to, you know, push a lot of pressure pretty soon, because it's a twin scroll turbo, so even at lower RPMs this turbo tends to spool and pushes too much air into the engine, bringing you into the LSPI, especially if you are at low RPMs. Like I said before, if you keep the engine happy above 3000 RPMs, it's a problem solved. But that means that you have to disregard the shifter indicator in the center that so far has been telling me to put sixth gear when I do not want to. You know, I need to keep my engine always above 3000 RPMs. What other things can you do to reduce the LSPI? Well, there is other things. Like I said, they say if you lose a certain type of synthetic lubricants, it's supposed to help preventing it. But I feel like doing that, it's kind of like trying to put the duct tape over a pothole. I mean, I'll show you. Let me make you feel the LSPI. I'm going to put... look, I'm going to go to fifth gear now, as the indicator says. And you can see my mileage is dropping. Now I go to sixth. And you can hear, right now I am in perfect LSPI. The engine is bogging down, and I don't want to stay here. I go back to fourth gear. I mean, I'm doing 50 miles an hour. Fourth gear, that's where I have to be. There is not much that I can do, and that's how I get a better gas mileage. And you can see in here, I mean, I'm doing 33.9 average gas mileage, and you can see in the consumption bar at the bottom how much I'm using. Typically speaking, if I am at 45 miles an hour, I need to be in third gear, and at 55, I can be in fourth gear. Fifth and sixth gears, I have to use at higher speeds. What I mean with the higher speeds? Well, you know, I need to be at least 65, 75 miles an hour. Right now, I'm in fourth gear, everything is working great. The car is telling me to put sixth, and I am in fourth. If look at the consumption bar on the bottom, I'm gonna go to fifth. And as soon as I went to fifth, you see how much the bar went down for the fuel consumption. That's not good. That's not what you want. You want the engine to rev up. You want the engine. You can listen to it to sound happy. And that's how you will prevent the LSPI. There is really not much of technical modifications that you can do to avoid LSPI. You can try to partially mitigate. There is some things. As we said, the LSPI tends to be generated by excess heat that forms in the chamber. Well, putting a cooler intake or a bigger intercooler will definitely help the issue. But still, it's not going to solve it. This car, the GDI, originally had a blow-off valve that vented the air from the turbo back into the air filter, basically backfeeding hot air into the engine. Again, not a good combination. That's the perfect combination to induce even more LSPI. So I put a pop-off valve to vent out the air. Even putting an exhaust that lets the car breathe better, like the one that I have on my car, you can probably hear that it's not a stock exhaust, and it allows me to hear when LSPI is happening, if it's happening. Generally, I avoid it because I never go below 3000 RPMs, but it allows me to hear if my engine is bogging down, and that's the main factor. I do understand that it is fun a lot of times to just be at 2000 RPMs and stomp on the throttle and try to cause the turbo to surge and let the car climb in the RPMs. It's nice to hear that, but in reality at that point you're surging the turbo. If you have a twin scroll turbo at 2000 RPMs, it's gonna start spooling up and pushing a lot of air into the engine, and the engine doesn't know what to do with it. Honestly speaking, if car manufacturers wanted to solve this problem, all they had to do is to put a little bit more fuel into the chamber and cause a partial flood of the engine, and that basically would lower the temperature. But they're not gonna do that because, you know, who wants to increase the amount of gas that a car drinks? Nobody does. So obviously, you know, car manufacturers, they're wary of how much the car uses in fuel, and these are the results. There is a lot of air going in the chamber and it can cause this LSPI. Like I said, the best way to avoid it, just keep driving above the LSPI range. In the case of the GDI Turbo, it's 2600 to 2900 RPMs. For that reason, I always drive above 3000, and that works just great. I have over 60,000 miles. Hope I'm not jinxing myself, but I never had a problem with my car in all these years. I used it to take quite long trips, and it's a lot of fun to drive, but you gotta know how to drive it. Like I said, the last two gears, 5th and 6th, they are for 65 miles an hour and over, and 75. And if you wonder why would they put the gears like that, just remember that these cars are sold all over the world. These are not cars that are sold just in America. They're sold also in other countries. And in a bunch of other countries, especially in Europe, where cars like this, they're very common, speed limits normally are between 80 and 90 miles an hour. And it's not that Honda is gonna make a different gearbox for a different country just because their speed limits are different. They're gonna put more gears, but in America you're gonna use up to what gear you want. If you want to get the best efficiency, you gotta keep it above 3000 RPMs. I mean, I'll go back here again. I'm doing 35 miles to the gallon. It's a pretty good mileage for this car, for a car like this. So if you want to use less fuel, keeping the RPMs low may not be quite the best thing to do. And as far as the other gears, well, I guess you'll use them only when you are in one of those states where they allow to travel at higher speeds, where you can, travel at 80 or 90 miles an hour, and then you can use even the 6th. See, right now, I'm a little bit too low to be in 5th gear, honestly. I just put 5th. I need to get at least 65. There I am. And now I can set the cruise control, and I'm working with the 5th gear. I'm doing 65 miles an hour. below the speed, really, I need to go in fifth, and there is no way that I can put the sixth. It is that simple. There is no magic gimmicks, unfortunately, to avoid the LSPI. The LSPI is always going to be part of the smaller engines with the big turbo. Fix the geometry turbo. Obviously, if you have a two-stage turbo with variable geometry, that's a different story, because those, they can literally change shape and reduce the pressure as needed. But they also don't make as much power. And now, since we are getting to an interstate, why not have some fun with it and just enjoy it? Yeah, it's a lot of fun, but this car can get you in trouble pretty quick. But look, speed limit in here is 70 miles an hour. I'm in fifth gear right now. And if I cheat a little bit and bring it to 75, I can engage sixth gear. And ta-da! I am now in sixth gear. We're in sixth. I mean, I'm closer to 80 miles an hour, but this is how you get your best gas mileage that you want. And you can see in a little bit, the cruise control will optimize the consumption, and the best part is that I avoided the LSPI all the way around. So, like I said, there is little modifications you can do. Pop-up valve, the vents out in the air rather than back into the air filter, is definitely something that you will want to consider to help reducing LSPI, because you don't want the hot air from the turbo to be blown back inside the air filter. But be careful on the type of air intake sensor that your car has. You know, some cars, they have MAF sensor, other cars, they have MAP sensors. You gotta be careful. Some cars will require you to remap the ECU if you put a pop-off valve. In the case of this car, I didn't need to. It was actually an easy modification that I did myself, and honestly, I love it. It sounds great when it releases pressure, and it helps reducing the LSPI, so that's great. But like I said, the best thing to do is just keep driving away from the LSPI range. In my case, 3000 RPMs has been the magic number that avoided me to have bad surprises like the ones that I read about on the internet. And on top of everything, gas mileage is pretty good. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope I clarified well what this LSPI is, so you can make your car last longer, because let's face it, electric cars are coming, and for us that like sports cars like I do, well, I want my car to last as long as possible, and this is what you gotta do. Thanks for watching. Ciao.